Everybody, how are you today? So today we're going to learn about medical problems, particularly about how to talk about your medical history. Your medical history, well, is the record of all the health problems, the medication, or all the things that you have been into, so your doctor knows and he's aware on how to help you when you have a problem. For example, something very important that you should tell your doctor is maybe about your allergies. So we have an example here. I have suffered from allergies all my life before I started taking this pill. I want you right now to focus particularly on the two verbs that we have highlighted in different colors. The first one in blue and the other one in red. What's the difference between one and the other? I mean, obviously they are two different verbs, but what's the difference in its structure? Had, suffered, and started. Can you notice? Well, the first one, I had suffered, it's a verb that is conjugated in past perfect, right? And how do we form past perfect? Well, we need the auxiliary have in simple past. And in that case, that is the verb had. And then we have the other verb that is in past participle, right? Okay. And now, the other verb started, well, that is simple okay? Now, why are these two tenses together? Why are they combined? In what situation can we use one and the other? Well, stay with me. The first one, we say, I had suffered from allergies. We say the past perfect because the action of suffering from allergies is in the past, before the other event, the other action mentioned in the sentence. In this case, the other action is taking the pill, right? So that happened before. And the verb started is in simple past because I took the pill in the past, but after having the allergy. So in this case, we have two events in chronological order. First, I suffered from allergies, and then I started taking the pill. So instead of doing two sentences separated, I could say, for example, first I suffered from allergies and then I started taking the pill, but that sounds very basic, very first level. What we can say is, I had suffered from allergies before I started taking this pill. In that case, it sounds better and it shows what happened first and what happened next. Let me give you some other examples. For example, this one is a little bit easier. The patient had left when the doctor arrived. What happened first? The patient left. What happened then? The doctor arrived. Probably the doctor was very late, so the patient didn't wait for him. So, first one thing and then the other. Lo que pasó primero, what happened first, goes in past perfect. And then what happened later in simple past. Another example. Mike had never had surgery before. So in this case, two events. I mean, one, we can infer that Mike had a surgery recently. But before that, he had never had a surgery before, right? First, no surgery, then a surgery. And this one is the easiest one of them all. The ER, you know, the emergency room, the ER was full because there had been an accident. What happened first? The accident. And that caused that the ER got full. Okay? So, I guess, I hope, the use of past perfect, it has been clear. It is like in Spanish. Emergencias estaba lleno porque había habido, like before in the past, an accident, okay? Very good. So that is how we use the past perfect. First, what happened first in past perfect and what happened later in simple past. But both actions are in the past. Just one had happened first and the other one happened next, okay? Let me know if you want me to give you a couple more examples, if you need some more explanation to understand it. So I think it's pretty clear, right? So let's take a look at the structure. In affirmative, we say that we need first the subject, de quien estamos hablando, in this case, I, then the auxiliary had, and then the verb in past participle. I had been okay until I came down with the flu. What happened first? I was okay. What happened later? I came down with the flu. Now, in negative, it's the same, but now we need the auxiliary to be in negative form. For example, I had not been in the hospital before this accident. Auxiliary had, now with the negative particle not. I had not been. If you want, you can use the contraction too, to make the negative. I hadn't been in the hospital before. Or, if you want, you can use instead the adverb never. Instead of not, never. I had never been in the hospital before. In both cases, remember that basically the only difference is that, for example, in the complete form, I had not, that's formal. And the contraction, I hadn't, that's a little bit more informal. So it's going to depend a lot on the context. The three forms are correct, okay? Well, now, what about the questions? In this case, remember, for making questions, what we need is to switch the place from the subject and the auxiliary. So instead of you had, we had you ever been in the hospital before? First auxiliary, then subject. Then you can use the adverb ever, alguna vez. That depends on how you want to structure your question. That's why it's in parentheses, because it's optional. And then the past participle, been. Have you ever been in the hospital before? And then for the answer, well, you use exactly the same auxiliary. Yes, I had. And then extra information. For example, I had a surgery 2 years ago. Oh, no, I hadn't, okay? I don't get sick too often, for example. So that's for the structure of the past perfect. I hope it's clear. Let me know if you got any question or if I can direct you to another explanation so you have it clear, okay? Very good. Let's click on the next video for the final grammar topic.